Every JoJo's Bizarre Adventure main antagonist, in Araki's beliefs, should have an overpowered stand ability to make them near unstoppable. These abilities have had a certain theme, and that theme is the manipulation of space and time. The 23rd President of the United States, Funny Valentine, continues this theme with his stand, Dirty Deeds Done Dirt Cheap.
Dirty Deeds Done Dirt Cheap.いともたやすく行われるえげつない行為。
Welcome to my stand analysis series, where I delve deep into as much detail about the ins and outs of a stand as possible. My aim is to eventually do an analysis on every stand within the anime and manga series JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. I hope you will continue to follow me on this unique and educational journey. In this week's video, we'll be analyzing the 138th stand to appear in the JoJo's Bizarre Adventure manga and anime series Funny Valentine's D4C.As always, please keep in mind that this video will be full of heavy spoilers for Part 7 Steel Ball Run, so if you haven't already read the manga, click off the video now. Although, if you have read the manga, or simply don't care about spoilers, get comfortable and grab a drink, because this is going to be another tough stand to talk about. Also, did you know? In every parallel world, the Bizarre Star Platinum YouTube channel doesn't actually exist. In fact, this world is the only world in which this channel exists, and creates educational stand analysis content on YouTube. Some might call this the root world for Bizarre Star Platinum. So if I were you, I'd take this opportunity to subscribe to the channel because your countless parallel selves don't have the same chance. So do it whilst you can. Funny Valentine acquired D4C as a soldier during his youth.He and his fellow soldiers wandered into the Devil's Palm during an army exercise in San Diego, which ended up in his entire company's death. The only survivor was Funny Valentine, who found the heart of the Saint's corpse, which revitalized his life. Let's begin, as always, with the stand's appearance. D4C manifests as an artificial humanoid stand with an athletic build similar to President Valentine's appearance later on in the manga.Along with its baby blue body colouring, it also features baby pink segments on its body, such as its shoulders and loincloth, as well as seams on its limbs, which are designed to replicate the appearance of leather being stitched together, similar to that of a baseball. Valentine's stand also features a masked jaw, as well as large upright horns, which resemble the ears of a rabbit. On top of that, D4C features dead empty eyes, and its chest features a plate which appears rather mechanical. Once Valentine has been aged by the effects of Gyro Zeppeli's his steel ball stand, Ball Breaker, D4C loses its masked face covering and its tall ears, and generally looks slightly different. Funny Valentine's stand's full name is Dirty Deeds Done Dirt Cheap, which is named after the famous song performed by rock band AC/DC. D4C features no personality of its own, and follows Funny's will completely.Valentine's stand has one of the strongest techniques in all of JoJo with its dimensional travel, however, we will discuss that very shortly. Putting this technique aside, however, being a close-ranged power-based stand, D4C has high destructive power and speed, as well as precision. However, like most stands, attacking the stand user is a big weakness to D4C. Other than that, D4C doesn't actually have many other major weaknesses that can be beaten, other than by stands with abilities that can manipulate time, gravity, or space, or stands that could do stuff such as possessing Funny Valentine himself. Of course, his opponents can also beat D4C by killing Funny before he is able to get between two objects. Other than this, D4C's strength, speed, and defense is incredible, and Funny has managed to hone his abilities immensely over the years.Now it's already time to talk about the main technique that D4C uses, and this is his dimensional travel technique. The transition between Part 6 and Part 7 of JoJo proved to us that multiple universes do exist in the world of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Funny's dimensional travel technique allows different parallel worlds to coexist at the same time and at the same place as the current dimension. Diego states that there are probably an unknown amount of parallel worlds out there, which gives Funny Valentine potentially unlimited uses for his stand's technique.First off, we have the basic use for D4C's dimensional technique, which has the ability to align parallel worlds together. This allows multiple parallel worlds to exist at the same place at the exact same time. Funny Valentine explains it by using sponges as an object of explanation. Two sponges come together, and the gaps align with each other, and become one. This symbolizes the same time and the same place in both universes becoming aligned. Time is represented by the metaphorical gaps in the sponges aligning.In other words, time lines up in both of these parallel worlds so that events happening in both worlds are happening at the same time. And because they are parallel worlds, the majority of the time, things that exist in one world will be paralleled in the next. The definition of parallel is occurring or existing at the same time or in a similar way, corresponding, such as a parallel universe. This is why Diego and Weka Pipo are in the same location at the same time in both worlds when fighting Funny Valentine, and also why there were two Funny Valentines appearing within each other. Once parallel worlds are aligned, the president can then travel freely to the parallel world by closing himself between two objects, such as between a wall and a door. Once he is squashed between these two objects, an invisible portal is created between the objects in which Funny enters. This then allows him to appear out of the same object within the parallel world. However, when returning to the root world, Funny Valentine has full control over where he reappears. He may return to the root world in a completely unexpected place. Since both time and space need to be aligned in both worlds to grant Funny the ability of traversing them, this also means that the Funny Valentine in the parallel world should be in the same vicinity as the president from the main world, including other characters such as Diego, Weka Pipo, and Johnny. This allows President Funny Valentine to swap positions with the parallel Valentine at will and in quick succession. This is an incredible defense mechanism, because if the main world's Funny Valentine becomes fatally wounded, he can traverse to another dimension and swap places with a healthy Funny Valentine almost instantly. When swapping places with a parallel President Valentine, D4C transfers from the original Funny over to the parallel one. This then allows the parallel Valentine to transfer back over to the main world using the powers of D4C. The main world in which Steel Ball Run takes place is the only world in which D4C exists. Funny Valentine refers to this world as the Root World, as this is the one and only world in which the Saint's corpse exists, and is also the only world in which Funny Valentine gained D4C. When Funny Valentine wills it, that is when D4C will transfer to whichever parallel version of himself that Funny wants. Using this power, the president can bring multiple parallel versions of himself into the root world to outnumber an enemy, but D4C can only attach itself to one version of Valentine at a time. Usually, this will be the one that he wants to survive. If he brings multiple parallels of himself into the root world, he will probably choose one at random to receive D4C. The main goal of presumably every version of Funny Valentine is the exact same, to acquire the Saint's corpse for the sake of America. When D4C transfers over, Funny Valentine's memories also transfer to the chosen parallel version of himself. Once D4C and Funny's memories transfer over to a parallel version, that parallel version becomes the root world's President Valentine. There is also seemingly no noticeable differences between versions of Funny Valentine, as their goals, ideologies, and personalities are practically the same. However, all versions of Funny Valentine are still separate entities and have their own separate consciousness. Now that we kind of understand the basics of how Funny's dimensional travel works, we will now move on to the various ways he can use this incredibly powerful technique. Not only can President Valentine transport himself to a neighboring world which is aligned with the root world, but he can transport other people and objects across worlds as well. If he closes another person or item between two objects, then they too can be transported to a parallel world of the president's choosing. He can go through the portal with the person, or he can trap them in the parallel world without following them. To stop his own body from breaking apart and being spread across different worlds during the dimensional hop, D4C makes sure that the forces of gravity persist with Funny, or anyone else who hops through the dimensional portals. This allows him or his target to survive the dimensional hop. Additionally to this, once President Funny Valentine enters a portal between worlds, he can freely move back and forth within the portal until he completely leaves it. This means he can sit in the portal between worlds, and then he can completely pull a person through the portal, or he can partially pull them through, trapping them inside the portal, unable to move. This is shown when Funny does this to Diego. Diego's top half entered the parallel world, whilst his bottom half is trapped in the root world. Whilst he could not maneuver back to the root world on his own, if another person entered the portal, it would reactivate it, allowing for Diego to then move back into the root world. Whilst this was happening, Diego and Weka Pipo found out the hard way that two versions of the same being or object cannot exist in the same world together. One of them would have to go back to their own dimension, because if they didn't and they got too close to each other, both people or objects would start to crumble, splitting into Menger sponges. This continuous breakdown continues until they are completely obliterated. So although President Valentine uses this dimensional travel technique primarily as a defense mechanism and a vehicle of potential immortality, it can also be used as a way of attacking and trapping an enemy. However, President Funny Valentine does not break down when touching his parallel world self, because the effect of D4C allows him to stay safe during this moment. Menger sponges are mathematical cubes, which are essentially fractal curves. I don't fully understand the concept of Menger sponges without doing a hell of a lot of research. However, they essentially symbolize infinity, which reflects in Funny Valentine's potentially unlimited capabilities with D4C. This also bounces off Johnny and Gyro's use of the golden spin, which is essentially an infinite rotation. As a side note here before we get into this anymore, this part that I'm speaking right now is completely unscripted, so I apologize if I fumble my words a little bit, but I have not recognized the Who Shot Johnny Joestar incident, where, if you remember rightly, it showed both Weka Pipo and Diego shooting Johnny Joestar, and they did not imagine it. This was a real occurrence, which both of these people witnessed. My theory on how that happened and how the manga tried to explain this with the sponge analogy is that because Funny Valentine had multiple parallel worlds existing at the same place and at the same time, he could make these worlds kind of merge together briefly, kind of distorting Weka Pipo and Diego's vision. I believe that Funny Valentine somehow transported Diego and Weka Pipo to a parallel world briefly and made them seem that they were shooting Johnny in parallel worlds, whereas it was actually President Valentine in the root world that shot Johnny. I mean, I might do a video on the Who Shot Johnny Joestar thing and just clear that up a bit, but to me it's quite obvious that it was actually all three of them that shot Johnny Joestar, but Diego shot him in a different world, Weka Pipo shot him in a different world, and then Funny Valentine shot him in the root world, and all three of them then came back together to the root world without even realizing what happened. Obviously Funny Valentine knew what happened, but Weka Pipo and Diego were oblivious. Anyway, now we've got that bit of unscripted buffoonery out the way, I'm gonna return to my script. On top of the conventional way of transferring across dimensions, such as between a door and a wall, or between a flag and the ground, liquid materials such as water also counts as an object. This means that if Funny is laying on the floor and gets rained on, or has water spilled upon him, he can use this to transport to a parallel world, as his body was closed in between the floor and the falling water. Funny can also close his body between an object and another person's body. Similar to how the object would turn into a portal to another world, the person's body would also turn into a portal, allowing Funny to traverse through the body at will without distorting the body's physical attributes, and without sending that person's body through into a parallel world. Because if a person's body is a portal, it can't exactly enter itself. Initially, projectiles shot towards Funny Valentine would go through his body, causing the shapes of Menger sponges to appear. This isn't really explained, and as far as I can recall, was not used again after the initial usage versus Diego and Weka Pipo, so it's open to interpretation. My theory on this idea was that he could send parts of his body temporarily into a parallel world to avoid damage. It was either that, or that he could send a piece of his body into a pocket dimension temporarily, which is essentially a gap within space. Maybe he could send a piece of his body that was going to be hit by the projectile into this gap in space very quickly, and then return it back to his body once the projectile has gone through, leaving him undamaged. However, I believe removing pieces of his body to avoid projectiles may have been quite overpowered, as it would have left President Valentine with almost no way of being attacked. Also, if he did send his body pieces into a little pocket dimension, and that idea was actually scrapped after the initial usage, I believe Araki decided to use the gap in space idea later on for Love Train, which is what we're about to start covering. We will now discuss the ability that Funny Valentine manages to acquire as a blessing from the Saint's corpse becoming completed. As I just stated, this ability is called Love Train. Some class this as an evolutionary form for D4C, however, I just see this as a new ability that was granted to the stand by the Saint's corpse. Love Train is an ability that emanates from Lucy Steele when she starts becoming the Saint's corpse, if that is the correct way to put it. This ability creates multiple gold-colored lasers that erupt from the ground and often surround Funny Valentine and D4C. These golden lasers create a pocket dimension that President Valentine uses to hide within. As I stated just before, this pocket dimension is a small gap in space, protected by the golden lasers. This grants the perfect protection to Funny Valentine. Nothing at all is proven to break through this golden impenetrable wall, except for the gravity-defying stand abilities of Tusk Act 4 and Ball Breaker. This gap in space can be managed by President Valentine as he sees fit, by manipulating gravity, which he does to give himself the power to levitate in midair, glide at high speeds, or flatten himself with no damage done to his body. Funny Valentine can freely leave the pocket dimension either by exiting it completely or by sticking a part of his body outside of the golden walls to attack an enemy. This is the only way that Valentine can attack a target. However, this also makes the body parts that exited the pocket dimension vulnerable to attacks. Love Train's ability can only be used at a certain distance away from Lucy. If she is moved away from him, then the wall of light is moved along with her, which means Funny will also be dragged along with her unless he leaves the pocket dimension. The first time that Gyro and Johnny notice something is wrong is when they spot that neutral and environmental objects seem to move closer and closer to the source of the Saint's Corps' power, which at this point is Lucy Steele. Signs, trees, and even the oceans move towards the corpse. Once Valentine learns how to use this properly, he begins to use this ability to manipulate the neutral objects to cut off Gyro and Johnny's movements. This ability can be really fatal as it can move cuts and scratches on a person's body to a different part of the body to benefit Funny's motive. For example, a scratch on Gyro's hand very quickly moved up his arm towards his heart. This ability of Love Train could make a small scratch a fatal injury if it moves onto the target's heart or brain. The final aspect of Love Train to talk about is its Misfortune Redirection ability. Any misfortune that touches the wall of light, such as a physical attack, are completely redirected and sent far away from Funny Valentine. This is a blessing from the Saint's Corps, which allows no misfortune to befall the one it blessed. This misfortune is then passed on to an individual person somewhere else on Earth, coming to them in the form of bad luck, usually resulting in someone's death. This is an insanely powerful defensive technique on top of Valentine's already defensive pocket dimension. Another unscripted segment here because I forgot to write this bit in last week when I wrote the script, but some people class this as an evolutionary stand form for D4C, however Love Train is nothing more than an ability granted by the Saint's Corps. Because Funny Valentine was the man who brought the Saint's Corps together again and completed it, Corps itself sees Funny Valentine as worthy and grants him the unimaginary power of Love Train. So really, this ability is only granted, it's not actually an ability that D4C has. I feel like Love Train would have been granted to any stand user who brought the Corps together. However, depending on the stand user, it may well have taken a different form than the pocket dimension and the wall of light. And now back to the script, I think it's actually now time for my final thoughts on D4C. Honestly, I actually really like this stand, and although it took a bit of time for me to understand how its power worked at first, by the end of Steel Ball Run I had mostly grasped the concept of dimensional travel and how Funny Valentine does it. I like how Araki also made it so open-ended by saying there was an unknown amount of parallel worlds, giving potentially unlimited scope for President Valentine to replace his body with parallel versions of himself forever. D4C also confirms the existence of a multiverse within the JoJo's Bizarre Adventure anime and manga series, which also confirms that the world within parts 1 through 6 are a completely separate universe to the one in part 7 and 8. I feel like this is common knowledge now anyway for manga readers, but I thought I'd include that piece of information just in case. I also had a thought of, I wonder how many times Valentine had already swapped bodies before the events of Part 7 Steel Ball Run began. Was the Funny Valentine we saw near the start of Part 7 the original 23rd President of the USA? I'm going to assume not, as he seemed adept at using D4C's abilities to transfer his stand over to various versions of himself, so it's like he had already done it multiple times before. Seeing as Valentine is so determined to complete his goal, none of his parallel versions seem to truly be scared of dying, as many of them had passed away from battle wounds just after transferring D4C to a new host. It seems they all have a common understanding and one common goal, so they are quite happy to die for the cause as long as one iteration of President Valentine completes their collective goal. President Funny Valentine is a colony stand confirmed. Now, in terms of just the pure fighting ability, D4C still stands above so many other stands by having high speed, attack, and defense. This alone makes D4C a ruthless opponent in a one-on-one stand battle. Many stands would fall victim to this pure power and speed alone, without even taking its dimensional travel or Love Train abilities into account. It has been shown that it is more than possible to mortally wound Funny Valentine in a regular physical battle, however he then needs to hurry to a space between two objects and transfer D4C to his parallel self before his life fades away. He also enters a dangerous position going into a parallel world. Due to time and space being aligned in parallel worlds, that means that the parallel President Funny Valentine will also be in the same battle that the root world President Funny Valentine would have just escaped from, so he needs to make sure that the parallel opponents don't quickly take him out before swapping over. Only a few stands would be able to defeat D4C Love Train, and those, as previously mentioned, are Tusk Act 4 and Ballbreaker, as they have gravity-defying abilities from utilizing the infinite rotational power of the Golden Spin, allowing them to break through into the pocket dimension. Other than those, I don't think there would be many other stands that could actually defeat Love Train's ability as it stands right now. It's possible Gold Experience Requiem could cancel out the Love Train ability, but considering the ability is granted by a literal saint, Requiem may not be able to reduce the ability to zero. I have not researched Gold Experience Requiem enough yet to make the call on this, but seeing as so many people asked me on my Tusk video if Gold Experience Requiem would beat Tusk Act 4, I'm going to say that Gold Experience Requiem could not defeat Love Train as long as Funny Valentine hid inside the pocket dimension. However, he will have to attack eventually. So as soon as he pokes a hand out to attack Giorno, I think Gold Experience Requiem could use that opening as a way to attack him. I also think that Maiden Heaven could potentially beat Love Train, as that stand's main technique, Time Acceleration, works with gravity as its basis, so it's possible that Poochie could manipulate gravity enough to bust through the walls of Love Train. Without Love Train, Funny Valentine is a lot more vulnerable. As long as his opponent removes all objects close to each other, the president would not have anywhere to close himself in, therefore not being able to activate his dimensional travel technique. Diego and Hot Pants did this on the train during the D4C arc to remove all possibilities of letting Funny get away, so they could inflict mortal wounds on him. The president is an incredibly smart man, however, and knows exactly how to use his stand's power, even knowing that falling water would count as an object. I feel that D4C is one of the most powerful stands in the entire series, and I know it feels like I've said that a lot recently, but if I had to rank a top 10, D4C would definitely be in it with Maiden Heaven, Gold Experience Requiem, Tusk Act 4, and more. That about does it for Filthy Acts at a reasonable price. I mean D4C. Funny's stand is one that you guys have been asking for a while now, and I hope this video helped you understand how the stand works a bit better. This one was a little more difficult to write about, but as I've said in the Silver Chariot video, I am learning more and more about the stands as I research them. I admit though, I am not at all perfect, and I may not get every single thing 100% correct. There are some aspects of a stand or their abilities that aren't outright explained fully by Araki, and are therefore left up to interpretation. This means I may explain it one way and you saw it a different way. I respect that, so I also hope you guys can respect that I may accidentally omit some information or get some pieces of information slightly incorrect. I apologize for any of these shortcomings. Either way, I hope you enjoyed this explanation of Dirty Deeds Done Dirt Cheap. What did you personally think of D4C? Did you like Love Train, or did you feel D4C was strong enough without it? Let me know in the comments down below. If you've enjoyed this video, then please consider subscribing to the channel for future JoJo content. Also, please hit the thumbs up button on this video if you want to see more stand analysis videos. To get notified when I release the next video, hit that bell and you'll be notified when I release another one. I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video, but until next time, Bizarre Star Platinum out.